In 1946, just months after the end of World War II, the United States conducted a series of atomic bomb tests called Operation Crossroads at Bikini Atoll in the Pacific. These tests were meant to see how these powerful new weapons would affect warships. The first test, named Able, took place on July 1st. The bomb, nicknamed Gilda, after a Rita Hayworth movie, was similar to the one dropped on Nagasaki. It was even carried by a B-29 bomber that witnessed the Nagasaki bombing. The plan was for Gilda to explode right above a target fleet made up of captured and outdated warships. The main target was the battleship USS Nevada, which was painted bright orange to stand out. Unfortunately, something went wrong, and the bomb missed its mark by almost half a mile. Despite the miss, the explosion still did damage. 5 ships sank, and 14 others suffered serious damage from the bomb's shockwave. The cause of the miss remains a mystery to this day, even after investigating the bomber crew and its instruments. Able was designed to explode in the air. This aimed to minimize radioactive fallout, the long-lasting radioactive contamination that can linger for years. The Able blast wasn't dirty with lingering radiation, but it did unleash a powerful, short-lived burst of radiation. Ships within a certain range would have received a lethal dose of neutron and gamma radiation, but the ships themselves wouldn't become radioactive. To study the effects of radiation on living things, researchers placed hundreds of animals on the target ships, including rats, pigs, and goats. Sadly, about 35% of these animals died or were euthanized after the test. Scientists also included mice kept outside the expected lethal zone. The idea was to study any mutations that might appear in future generations of these mice to understand the long-term genetic effects of radiation. Even though Able missed the USS Nevada by a large margin and failed to sink the battleship, the crew wouldn't have stood a chance. Target ships within range received a massive dose of radiation, 10,000 rems, while a dose of just 500 rems is considered fatal. In a real attack, a targeted ship would likely be left as a ghost ship, devoid of life. 3 weeks later, on July 25th, the US conducted a second test called Baker. Unlike Able, Baker wasn't dropped from a plane. Instead, it was suspended underwater in the middle of the target fleet. This underwater detonation made Baker the world's first nuclear disaster. The underwater explosion wasn't like the blinding flash of Able, but Baker created an immense pressure wave that crushed the hulls of nearby ships within 1,000 yards, sinking 10 of them. On the surface, it appeared as a dark ring expanding outward, followed by a white, foamy area. This was the first time a nuclear bomb was detonated close enough to the Earth's surface to trap radioactive material in the environment. The result? Radioactive contamination of the surrounding lagoon and the target ships. While scientists expected some contamination, it was much worse than anticipated. The force of the blast pushed a massive column of water and sand over a mile high and half a mile wide. At the same time, it carved a deep hole in the seabed. Upon reaching the air, the blast caused a brief fog to appear. The water eventually collapsed back down into the lagoon, creating a kind of tsunami. Falling water from the collapsing column also formed a massive base surge wave that swept over the ships, coating them in radioactive material. The USS Arkansas, the closest ship to the bomb, took the brunt of the force. Its steel hull crumpled like paper, flipping the battleship upside down. Divers later found the Arkansas's mangled remains resting on the seabed. Experts are unsure if the battleship's superstructure is buried beneath the wreck or was torn off in the blast. The aircraft carrier Saratoga, though farther away, wasn't spared either. The shockwave tore through the ship, opening massive leaks in its hull. Planes on deck were tossed overboard, and she began taking on water. While the Saratoga remained afloat, it was drenched in contaminated seawater. Repair crews were unable to board the carrier due to the dangerous levels of radiation, and she eventually succumbed to the waves. Operation Crossroads was the first public nuclear test after World War II, and it attracted significant media attention, especially pertaining to the use of animal testing. Thousands of animals were placed on the target ships. These unfortunate creatures were meant to serve as living stand-ins for humans, enduring the bomb's effects firsthand. The results were grim. The second test, Baker, proved even more lethal to the test animals than Able. The radioactive seawater spewed across the target ships contaminated everything it touched, and nearly all of the pigs and rats used exclusively in this test died. Publicly, officials downplayed the suffering of the animals, claiming their deaths were painless. This was a blatant lie. The horrors of radiation sickness were already known, both from the deaths of scientists exposed at the Los Alamos nuclear facility and the civilian casualties in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Operation Crossroads faced a major hurdle after the Baker test: widespread radioactive contamination. While scientists expected some contamination, no one anticipated the underwater detonation coating nearly all of the target ships in a layer of radioactive seawater. Unprepared for such a scenario, there were no proper decontamination procedures. Sailors used traditional methods like scrubbing with hoses and soap, which not only failed to remove the radiation but also spread it further. Adding to the danger, radiation badges worn by the crew showed alarmingly high exposure levels. Dr. Stafford Warren, the on-site radiation safety officer, became increasingly concerned, especially about plutonium, a highly radioactive element undetectable by the tools available at the time. Initially, Vice Admiral William Blandy, in charge of the operation, dismissed Warren's concerns and believed the cleanup efforts were working. However, Warren's persistence and the presentation of an autoradiograph, an X-ray created using the radiation emitted by a contaminated fish, finally convinced Blandy of the severity of the situation. On August 10, 1946, with few uncontaminated ships and limited resources, Operation Crossroads was discontinued. This effectively shut down plans for Test Charlie, the final bomb in the series that aimed to study the effects of a deep underwater detonation. The public wouldn't learn about the failed cleanup for another year. To avoid bad press, officials played down the contamination and claimed Test Charlie's cancellation was due to sufficient data already collected. But the truth was far more serious. The radioactive mess and the lack of uncontaminated ships made further testing impossible. Operation Crossroads stands as a stark reminder of the immense destructive power of nuclear weapons, the dangers of radioactive contamination, and the lack of proper safeguards in place during the early years of the atomic age.
Young men with war-tempered nerves, steeled in battle, awaited coolly for bomb away. Learned scientists awaited tensely below to study the effects. As the metronome ticked away the eventful seconds, the world in questioning suspense waited. Unspoken was the question, what will happen? Peaks into the power of the universe,